Hi, April.
Hi, Angela.
Good morning.
Drew called us in here for a meeting. You know what that's all about?
I have no idea. Maybe it's something the kids did or something.
Oh. Hope it wasn't my kid.
Hey.
Are we in trouble?
Yes, everybody's in trouble. We need to chat. Let's sit down.
So what's up?
Well, Arlene and Angela brought it to my attention. We've had some neighbors asking some questions. And I think we probably should have talked about this before we moved over. But as it is, we need to have a cover story now so we keep our story straight. I know that's stressful. I'm sorry to have to bring it up, but I'd like some thoughts on where we'd like to, how we'd like to proceed. One of the things that I hate about the lifestyle is not being able to be open with it. As a plural family, when everybody lives in a different home, it's a lot less conspicuous. So we knew if we're moving into one home altogether, that there would be a lot more suspicion. As an attorney and polygamist in Utah, I'm under extra pressure because I'm in the public eye and visible, and that's something that's not desirable here. And although we want to move and get outside of Utah, I have a caseload, and I've got to wrap that up before I can retire.
I just wish we could just be open about it. I've done this too many times. I was kind of secretly hoping when we moved to this house, perhaps we'd be done with that. I understand with the way that this neighborhood is set up that that's not a good possibility, but I wish it wasn't there.
There's just too much at stake.
I just hate this. I just wish that we could just be honest and be who we are. I hate having to come up with something. It doesn't feel right to me.
Agreed. Yeah, I don't like it either, but the consequences are a bit heavy to try that gamble.
I'm so torn because I don't like the running and the hiding. If it was up to me, we would just be open, come what may. But then again, I'm the one who has the least risk in the family, and so it just puts me in a really difficult place.
Essentially, we have to lie to protect our own family. And I don't like it either, but there is no way I want to risk going to jail. Who would raise my son?
Having just joined the Briney family, I've never had to deal with this. Some nights I literally am kept awake thinking about being separated from my son and him being a ward of the state and raised by somebody else.
This feels like we're backed up into a corner and we don't have a lot of options.
Yeah, it's terrible. What does everybody want to do?
Well, because I'm the only legal wife, I've been the one that's kind of the face, but I don't want you guys to be like resentful of me for having to do that.
I know this is a sensitive topic, but I can't help that I'm the one that married you first. I really don't like it when I feel resented.
It's not something I'm trying to take away from you. It's just, I'm the only one that legally has Drew's name.
It's not something to take lightly. If the repercussions weren't very drastic and it's just people being rude to us,
yeah,
I think that's one thing. But April doesn't have those repercussions hanging over her head.
Absolutely I do. I would be losing my husband too. There's different repercussions. But it would definitely be something that would affect me too.
So, I can be the visiting aunt.
That's a good idea.
What about you?
She can be the live-in nanny.
Yeah, I can do that. And that's believable, you know, especially with such a large family.
I think we can pull that off.
Is it a risk to put everybody together under one roof? Yes, but it's a risk to be a plural family in the state of Utah, and there are thousands of them.
I think that it'd be good to kind of refrain from any affection outside or maybe even be cautious that way and just live a normal life inside, but outside just keep things toned down.
It's like it's not an easy decision to be on a show like this. And why are you doing this?
We need people to see that plural families are normal people. It's a normal alternative lifestyle. And we need more families to be able to open up to show that there are lots of plural families with normal, good people. And then we can have hopes to change the law and allow all of us to live in peace and harmony with everybody else.
Okay, so how do we go about telling the kids?
That's a good question.